Welcome everybody, with you Dr. Magdi Abdelrazik, Consultant of Infectious Disease, Hepatology and Gastroenterology. Our topic today is brucellosis. This disease is considered zoonosis, transmitted from infected animals to human beings. This disease usually affects the people who work with animals, like butchers, hunters, vegetarian people, and also the people who consumed undercooked meat or unpasteurized milk or dairy products. This disease sometimes come in acute condition, sometimes in chronic condition. It affects many animals like sheep, like cattle, camels, also affects dogs and pigs. This disease the patient suffer from fever. This fever, indolent fever, usually accompanied by myalgia, arthralgia, and usually also accompanied by night sweating. The disease sometimes makes complications like orchitis, spondylitis, sometimes affect the liver and make hepatic abscess. Sometimes affect spleen and lead to splenomegaly. Sometimes affect central nervous system and lead to neuroprocellosis. Sometimes affect heart and lead to endocarditis. And sometimes mortality come from this complication, endocarditis. This is dangerous. So, as regards this disease, there is vaccination to animals, but no vaccination to men. As regards the treatment, we give usually doxycycline 100 mg twice per day for 6 weeks, accompanied by injection of streptomycin 1 gram daily intramuscular for 2 weeks. Sometimes we give also rifampicin 600 mg before breakfast with doxycycline 100 mg twice per day for 6 weeks or more. If there is neuroprocellosis, sometimes we give doxycycline and rifampicin and cotrimoxazole. If affect endocarditis, sometimes may make surgery. How can I diagnose this disease? From the history, if this patient work with animals like hunter, like farmer, like butcher, vegetarian, all these people, we can put diagnosis of brucellosis, especially if there is fever, myalgia, arthralgia, or sweating at night. Also, sometimes we make some investigations like tube agglutination test. Sometimes we make biopsy from blood, from bone marrow. Sometimes biopsy from the liver to diagnose the condition. Sometimes make radiological test for lumbosacral regions. also CPC sometimes find anemia, leukopenia, lymphocytosis. Sometimes find hepatic enzymes high. As regards this disease, we have to take care during work with animals or its secretions. We have to put in gloves, goggles, and avoid contact directly or indirectly with animals, except after sanitary precautions. And we have to wash our hands continuously. And also, all animals must be vaccinated. Some developed countries declared vaccinations of all its animals against Brucella. As I told you, this disease, we diagnose it by tube agglutination test. So we consider 1 over 160 is significant in non-endemic area. But in endemic area, we consider 1 over 320 is significant to diagnose brucellosis. But take care. These antibodies sometimes become high for years. So I advise doctors, don't repeat courses of antibiotic because these antibodies take years until come down. So please don't repeat multiple courses for antibiotic to treat brucellosis. Sometimes we resort to surgery if the condition is endocarditis. This disease is present in our countries, in Arab countries, in Italy, in Israel, in Malta. This disease present in underdeveloped countries. So we take care from consume fresh dairy milks without pasteurization of milk or eating or drinking dairy products like fresh cheese. All this avoid consumption of all these products. And also as regards the meat, it's usually over 65 centigrade boiling from half an hour to more than 1 hour. This is enough to kill the bacteria. Thank you very much.